Biz Basics Flourish Edition, week 13. We are asked this week to build a box and whisker plot. We are given a relatively small number of observations to accomplish this task. All we're going to be given is the mean temperature, Fahrenheit and Celsius, for the 8 planets plus Pluto. Now, when I was growing up, it was 9 planets, but now it's 8 planets plus Pluto. So we only have 9 observations here. So there's a fairly limited amount of data that we can work with. So I grab the data and I bring it in over here. So this is the first box and whisker plot or box plot that I created. And so you can see here, we've got the mean temperature for each of these planets. And the default bop up is just gonna be this table. Let me show you the data real quick. Planet name, mean temperature Fahrenheit, mean temperature in Celsius, and then an image. So I'm actually going to grab an illustration of each planet and bring it into Flourish. And I'll show you how to do that in just a second. But this is what I created. This is sort of the default. I don't love this. It's fine, but it's not particularly interesting. Now, there is a particular, I would say, issue with creating a box and whisker plot in Flourish that I don't love. Two things, really. One, as you can see, my labels here for Saturn and Jupiter, they're right next to each other, kind of on top of each other. Same thing over here. These labels are on top of each other. And I can't move those separately. Unless I bring this into a story and do it separately, I can't do it in the visualization directly. So I don't love that. Secondly, with the interactivity, if I click on Venus in this default or hover over it, I get this little table, great. Get a table over here too. But when I want to get, say, the value for Mars, it's only the values for the table. So I can't actually click on the data values inside the box. So I don't love that. So those are two things that sort of lead me not to want to create this particular graph in Flourish. But with that all being said, let's create it, because that's the point of this project, is just to see what works and what doesn't work. So I'm going to show you what I ultimately created. This is the final version that I created. Again, I don't love the labels here, but okay. You're also going to see that when I go into here, I actually have a little illustration, a little drawing of each of the planets, which again, I can do here. But when I hover over the box, I don't even get the values of the percentiles in the box. So it's a trade-off. I can customize these pop-ups to get it looking a little bit better, but only for a few of these planets, and I can't even do it for the full box. So that's the trade-off, and that's what we have to deal with. So let me show you how I created this. So let me first copy these data. Oh, let me tell you about the image real quick. Real simple. I grab these images from Shutterstock or Pexels or one of the places that I go for icons, and I created each of the 9 separate icons in a PNG. I right-clicked in this cell, clicked upload file, and just brought it right in. If you have a URL, if it's out on the web, you just grab it. Just copy the URL and bring it in. But I didn't have that, so I just uploaded it directly to Flourish. So I'm going to copy and paste these 4 columns, and let's go create a new visualization in my week 13. It's down here in the scatter area, so they call it a box plot, so perfectly fine. So I'm going to go over here and click box plot, and I'm going to immediately just go right to my data tab. I'm going to clear everything out of here, and I'm going to paste in my data. Just paste it. Okay. So again, planet, mean temperatures Fahrenheit, mean temperature Celsius, and the image. So let's take a look at what it looks like right now. Looks like a scatter plot. I don't want that. So let's go into the data tab. So X values are going to be the mean temperature Fahrenheit. I don't have Y values here, so let's turn that off. The name will be column A. Color, I'm not going to change the color here differentially by row, so I don't need that. And then for my pop-ups, I just want to give myself everything. I've gotten in the habit here of just giving myself everything in this box, because it doesn't affect what's in the visualization, and it just gives me the option to pick anything I want when I actually create my custom pop-up. So I'm just going to select everything. And now let's see what we got. All right, now we're getting somewhere. So as you can see, there's only one color possible here, because I didn't define a color variable. So let's close this, because I want to start with the background. So again, I thought like, oh, I'll make something that looks a little bit different, and let's create a background, and I'll just make that background black, space color. And I don't even love kind of like the full black. So I'm gonna try with an image instead. So I grabbed an image from Unsplash, one of my favorite photo sites. And I put it on my desktop and I grabbed it. And now this takes a little bit of time. I don't know why it takes kind of a long time for it to load. Maybe because the file size is large, because the images on Unsplash tend to be large and they are high quality. So the image itself here takes a little bit of time to load. But once I have it in, I'm good. So there I go. I've got my image. That looks pretty good. I will say parenthetically here, I don't know if this image and the planets on top sort of align. I'm sure they don't, but I'm just trying something here. All right, so we're just going to make some changes throughout this graph. We're going to start with the x-axis. So I don't want to have my grid lines. Those are at the bottom. I'll turn those off. I do want to be able to see the labels. So let's style those labels. Let's make the angle 0, and let's make the text white. That looks good. And let's also make the title white. That stands out. The other thing that we can do here is actually when we go to the labels, if I can remember how it is, the number styling, we can actually put a degree here. We can put the degree symbol. So if I go back to data, the degree symbol is actually in here. So like the little circle and then F. So I'm actually going to put that in here in the suffix. I'm going to create that, and now I've got degrees. So that looks good. I like that. Let's turn off the y-axis. I don't need that for this one. Let's change the dot styles. Just make them white. There we go. There's opacity already on it, so I don't need to change that so they can kind of see the overlap. Let's add a title. Now, I think I had a good one. I think I had a good one here. Planet temperatures in our solar system. Yeah, that's not terrible. Let's do that. And let's also, while we're here in layout, let's change this font to Roboto Condensed. Oops. And the header, don't forget, because the default is black, so it's here. You can barely see it right there. So I'm going to style and change that color to white. And let's make it bigger. And that looks good. All right, last thing is change the pop-up. So right now it's that default little table there. I don't love that. So we're going to customize this. And in the header, we'll put the planet name and make sure that works. Okay, that looks good. And in the custom, for the main part here, I want to add my image. So I'm going to go back and grab my code, which I've already got set up here. So I'm going to copy that and bring it over here, and I'll show you what it's got. So I've got the mean temperature. I'm going to list mean temperature. That's in bold font, and then the mean temperature, the value. So let's see if that works. There we go. See, it's sitting right there. And then I also want to have the image. And you can see here it's a little bit of HTML code that actually you could find on the Flourish site. So I didn't have to write this myself. It's just a background image equal to the name of that variable. And you can see I've got my little Venus image in here. I go over here. I've got Mercury. And I've got the dwarf planet Pluto, et cetera, et cetera. Actually, I think in my final one, I actually added some labels. So let's add some labels here. Dot labels. Turn those on. Put those above. Center them on top. That's what I want. Above is what I want. And we can probably make these a little bit bigger. Just make those bigger. So there you go. There you have it. And, you know, again, I don't love the overlap of the labels. I don't love this. There's no way to fix this. So I think this works for the static version. I think if I was like, I have to use Flourish for this project, what I would end up doing is turning these labels off. And I would take this image, I would save it as a PNG, bring it into Canva or bring it into PowerPoint or bring it into another design tool and add the labels on manually and then save that out again. The interactive version isn't great here because of this issue, even though I do love being able to add this little icon here, but I don't know, doesn't work great. So, you know, it's fine. I think it's a good tool. As you can see, it's easy enough to create the Box and Whisker plot. I forgot one thing now that I'm just staring at this. The one thing I wanted to add is I want to make these lines white. So if you're wondering about that, you just go to the Box, Violin, and Beastman plot tab, change the line color to white. There we go. Now we can see it. So that's the final chart. This is the one that I ended up putting in into the collection so that you can see it and you can play around with it. So hopefully that was useful. I'd be curious to see what you're creating in Flourish. for this Back to Viz Basics project. So be sure to tag me and tag the Back to Viz Basics team and use the hashtag B2VB, and I'll take a look and let me know what you think. All right. Thanks for watching.